In this video, we're continuing on with the adding and subtracting radicals expressions worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the Infinite Algebra 1 section, picking up where we left off with number 11. For number 11, we're going to need to first simplify the square root of 12. And in order to do that, we're going to find a perfect square that goes into 12, which is 4. 4 times 3 equals 12. But 4, I'll rewrite as 2 squared. So now I'll have the opposite of the square root of 2 squared times 3, and I'll be adding that to 3 times the square root of 3. Now remember, when you add or subtract radical expressions, you need to have the same value within the radical in order to add or subtract. So when I pull out this 2, because the square root of 2 squared is 2, I'll have opposite of 2 times the square root of 3 plus 3 times the square root of 3. And now you see, I have the same value for my radical, so I can add together. Negative 2 plus 3 is equal to 1, so I'll have 1 times the square root of 3, which 1 times the square root of 3 is simply the square root of 3. So that's my solution in number 11. Continuing on to number 12, I'm going to need to simplify the square root of 27. 27, a perfect square that goes into 27 is 9, and that's 9 times 3. That's equal to 27. And 9 we'll rewrite as 3 squared, so we'll have 3 squared times 3 equal to 27. So we'll have 3 times the square root of 3 minus the square root of 3 squared times 3. So I'll be able to pull out that 3 since it has an exponent of 2. So I'll have 3 times the square root of 3 minus 3 times the square root of 3. 3 times the square root of 3 minus 3 times the square root of 3 is 0 times the square root of 3, which is 0. That's my solution in number 12. Let's continue on to the second page. In number 13, I'm going to need to rewrite the square root of 8. So we'll have 3 times the square root of 8, which 8 can be simplified to 2 times 4, where 4 is that perfect square of 2 squared. So 2 times 2 squared is equivalent to 8. So I'll have 3 times the square root of 2 times 2 squared plus 3 times the square root of 2. So I'll be able to pull out that 2, so I'll have 3 times 2 times the square root of 2 plus 3 times the square root of 2. 3 times 2 is 6, and I'm multiplying that by the square root of 2, and then adding that to 3 times the square root of 2. 6 times the square root of 2 plus 3 times the square root of 2, 6 plus 3 is 9, so that's 9 times the square root of 2 as my solution in number 13. Now number 14, my radicals are already equivalent, the square root of 6 and the square root of 6. So what I'm going to do is add negative 3 to 3 to get 0, so that'll be 0 times the square root of 6, which is equal to 0. And again, if you want to think about this as reverse distribution, you'll have negative 3 plus 3, and if you pull out that square root of 6, you can multiply it back in to get negative 3 times the square root of 6 plus 3 times the square root of 6. Those two expressions are equivalent. Negative 3 plus 3 is 0, so you'll have 0 times the square root of 6, which we know is 0. And number 15, I'm going to be simplifying that radical of 20. So I'll have 20 equivalent to 4 times 5, which is 2 squared times 5. So that's negative 3 times the square root of 2 squared times 5, and then I'm subtracting the square root of 5. So when I pull out a 2, my radicals will be equivalent. So I'll have negative 3 times 2 times the square root of 5 minus the square root of 5. Negative 3 times 2 is a negative 6, and that's multiplied to the square root of 5, and I'm subtracting the square root of 5. So essentially subtracting 1 times the square root of 5. Negative 6 minus 1 is a negative 7, and I'm multiplying that by the square root of 5. So I'll have negative 7 times the square root of 5 as my solution in number 15. In number 16, I'll be simplifying the square root of 45. 45, in order to get 5 within the radical, I need to multiply 5 by a perfect square, so that'll be 5 times 9. That's equal to 45. And that perfect square of 9, I can write as 3 squared. So 5 times 3 squared equals 45. So I'll have 2 times the square root of 5 times 3 squared minus 2 times the square root of 5. pulling out my 3, I'll have 2 times 3 times the square root of 5 minus 2 times the square root of 5. 2 times 3 is 6, so that's 6 times the square root of 5, and I'm subtracting 2 times the square root of 5. 6 minus 2 is 4, so I'll have 4 times the square root of 5. That's my solution in number 16. In number 17, I'll be rewriting the square root of 18. 18 is 2 times 9, so that I'll have a 2 within my radical, and that's 2 times 3 squared. So I'll rewrite 3 times the square root of 18 as 3 times the square root of 2 times 3 squared. And I'll be subtracting 2 times the square root of 2. So pulling out my 3, I'll have 3 times 3 times the square root of 2 minus 2 times the square root of 2. 3 times 3 is 9, so 9 times the square root of 2 minus 2 times the square root of 2 will equal 9 minus 2, which is 7, times the square root of 2. Now in number 18, I have 3 separate values within my radical. However, there's perfect squares that fit into 18, 8, and 24. So I'm going to simplify all 3. Starting with 18, the largest perfect square is 9. So that's 9 times 2, which is 3 squared times 2. So I'll have negative 3 times the square root of 3 squared times 2. And I'll be adding that 2, simplifying 8. 8, I can write as 2 times 4, where the largest square root is 2. So that's 2 times 2 squared, or 2 squared times 2, because multiplication is commutative. So then 3 times the square root of 8, I'll write as 3 times the square root of 2 squared times 2. And then lastly, I'll be subtracting the square root of 24, which 24 I'll rewrite as 4 times 6, which is 2 squared times 6, simplifying that. So the square root of 2 squared times 6. Now let's pull out all my bases with exponents of 2. So I'll have negative 3 times 3 times the square root of 2, pulling out the 3, and I'll be adding that to 3 times 2 times the square root of 2, pulling out the 2, and then I'll subtract 2 times the square root of 6, pulling out another 2. Negative 3 times 3 is negative 9 times the square root of 2, plus 3 times 2 is 6 times the square root of 2, and then I'm subtracting 2 times the square root of 6. Now note that I have two radicals that are the same, but the square root of 6 is not the same as the square root of 2, and I cannot simplify that any further. So I'll just be combining my like terms, which are my terms that have radicals of 2. So negative 9 plus 6 is negative 3 times the square root of 2, and then I'm still subtracting 2 times the square root of 6. That's my final solution in number 18. Let's continue on to number 19. In number 19, again, I'll be able to simplify 18, 12, and 27 because there's perfect squares that go into each of those numbers. For 18, that perfect square is 9. So 2 times 9, I'll write as 2 times 3 squared. For 12, that perfect square is going to be 4. So I'll have 3 times 4, which is 3 times 2 squared. And then for 27, that perfect square is 9. So I'll have 3 times 9, which is 3 times 3 squared. So rewriting each of these, I'll have 3 times the square root of 18, which I'll now write as 2 times 3 squared, plus 3 times the square root of 12, which I'll now write as 3 times 2 squared, and then 2 times the square root of 27, which I'll now write as 2 times the square root of 3 times 3 squared. So pulling out all my bases with exponents of 2, I'll get 3 times 3 times the square root of 2 plus 3 times 2 times the square root of 3 plus 2 times 3 times the square root of 3. 3 times 3 is 9, so I'll have 9 times the square root of 2 plus 3 times 2 is 6, so that'll be 6 times the square root of 3 plus 2 times 3 is 6, and that's 6 times the square root of 3. Now I have two radicals that are the same. That's the square root of 3 and the square root of 3. So I'll combine 6 times the square root of 3 and 6 times the square root of 3 together. So my final solution will be 9 times the square root of 2, since that cannot be combined with anything else or simplified further. And then I'll be adding 6 plus 6, which will be 12, and that's multiplied to the square root of 3, since 6 times the square root of 3 plus 6 times the square root of 3 equals 12 times the square root of 3. So my solution at number 19 is 9 times the square root of 2 plus 12 times the square root of 3. And lastly, in this video, I'll go over number 20. For number 20, my square roots are already simplified. There's no perfect square that can go into 5 or 6. So I'll just combine my like terms. I have two different terms where the radicals are the square root of 5, so I'll combine those. Negative 3 minus 1 times the square root of 5 will be negative 4 times the square root of 5. And then I'll still have to subtract the square root of 6. So negative 4 times the square root of 5 minus the square root of 6 is my solution in number 20. If you haven't done so already, go ahead and click that subscribe button, and while you're at it, like this video. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated. Continue on to the next video, where I'll finish out this worksheet, completing numbers 21 through 28.